is also Sagirova, representing also Mikhail Burtsev, I understand.
Correct.
Please go ahead.
Okay, thank you. Let me share the slides. Okay, do you see my slides?
Yes.
Great. So, hello, dear colleagues. My name is also Sagirova, and I'm presenting the talk called Complexity of Neural Symbolic Representation in Working Memory Correlates with the Complexity of Task. So here is the outline of my talk. Firstly, I will state the research problem. Then I will describe the working memory we implemented in transformer architecture, present the data sets we used for analysis and for training our model, discuss the results, and conclude. So, working memory implements a cognitive function that makes possible to retrieve and manipulate with stored information. In our experiments, we work with transformer model, which successfully deals with many natural language processing tasks. Especially, we work with machine translation tasks. And transformer architecture uses only given inputs to make a prediction. However, additional contextual knowledge is often needed for better perception of the process text. And to store such knowledge, we use working memory. So the goal of our research is to study how working memory is used by the transformer model to solve machine translation tasks. To do that, we add working memory to the transformer decoder to retrieve and utilize contextual knowledge. We explore then relations between working memory content and real translations from the data and predictions of the model. And finally, we study how a complexity of translated sentences affects features of tokens in working memory. Let me start with three works related to the usage of memory in neural network models. First is a neural Turing machine, or NTM in short. It uses a controller network, a separate network with heads, read heads and write heads to manipulate with memory. Second work is extended transformer construction, or ATC, which uses special global input tokens that contain summarized information about the input sequence. And also ATC implements a special global local attention mechanism to work with memory tokens and standard input tokens. Final work is memory transformer, where memory is presented by specially reserved tokens concatenated to the input sequence. And this extended sequence is processed as usual by the transformer model. So now working memory in transformer. By using working memory, we allow the model to decide whether a currently predicted token will go to the target translation or to the memory. To do that, we augment standard target input, which here you can see as yinp, with additional vector called the vector of memory tokens. This vector is binary and has the same length as decoder input sequence. And each element of the token type vector is equal to one for the tokens which go to the target predictions and is equal to zero for the memory tokens. So here you can see the example where target tokens and memory tokens are mixed in our input sequence, and vector mInp helps us to understand where memory tokens are placed and where we have our target prediction. While training, before calculating loss, we filter out the slots from decoder predicted sequence corresponding to the memory tokens, because we don't have golden targets for tokens stored in memory. On this slide, you can see the results of our experimental evaluation of standard transformer model. end of our experiments with different memory augmentation invariants, different decoding schemes for memory tokens, and two schemes for training model with working memory. We evaluated our models on Russian, TED Russian English machine translation dataset, and calculated two metrics for machine translation. It's Meteor and Blur. For both metrics, the best score we achieved for the model where we have combined training with first five epochs training baseline model, which is a standard transformer, and then training 15 epochs with addition of working memory into the transformer decoder. And for decoding strategy of memory tokens, we used the nucleus sampling with parameter equal to 0.9. You can see that this variant of the model with working memory gives for both metrics best scores for 20 epochs training and also beats baseline score. Now the data for analysis of working memory content. We use two data sets. First is a test set from TED Russian English translation data set, which we refer as a test as a set of simple texts, because this data set contains transcriptions of TED Talks. And the texts are relatively simple and easily both in lexical and grammatical terms. And the second data set is contains paired sentences of Vinograd schemas for Russian language and for English language, which were taken from the Vinograd schema challenge data sets for Russian and English correspondingly. And as soon as Vinograd schemas are built to have an ambiguity in the text, we refer this data set as complex sentences. Our predicted translations lengths range from 9 to 48 tokens. And as I already said, we trained our transformer with working memory in decoder on train set from TED Russian English translation dataset. Here are some details about our model. We used transformer with four layers in encoder and four layers in decoder. And we bounded the size of memory in decoder for 10 tokens. So the memory contains only 10 tokens, but its content may vary. For example, all 10 tokens can be filled with a single repeating token or have several groups of identical tokens or even contain 10 different tokens. So we want to analyze how diverse is the memory content. To do that, we calculate the number distribution of number of tokens stored in working memory for both datasets. And the figure you can see on the left side. To sum up, memory content is more diverse for more complex sentences from Vinograd schema dataset. For example, here you can see that most frequently Vinograd samples contain five tokens, five unique tokens in memory. And for TED sentences, which are simpler in content, the most frequent case is just a single token filled in the memory. We also checked the distributions of parts of speech in memory. So how many parts of speech are stored in our working memory, both for both data sets. And from distributions, you can see that more parts of speech stored in VSC samples, which refer as more complex texts. On this slide, you can see the examples of sentences from the data set for both datasets, TED and VSC, and the model predictions for corresponding sentences. Here we depict tokens of start and end of the sequence. A usual text presents the model prediction of translation, and in parentheses there are memory tokens. to understand what elements of the translated text are important for the model, we extracted from both predicted translations and reference translations, which are golden targets from the dataset, we extracted keywords. So the words that summarize the idea of the text. And plotted the distributions of matches between the tokens of memory and these extracted keywords. You can see that for TED samples, one or two token keywords appeared in the memory tokens. And for VSC, we found no keywords in the memory. Next, we checked whether any content words that have semantical meaning are stored in our working memory for both datasets. On the left plot, you can see the distribution of number of content words in memory. And we can say that for more complex texts, one or two content words occur more frequently than for simpler texts from TED dataset. And on the right plot, you can see the average value of content words in memory for different translation lengths. And here, for more complex texts, the average number of content words grows with the translation length. And for simpler texts, it closely stays the same. And finally, we checked how the diversity in memory content depends on the translation length. And we compared memory diversity both for lengths of predicted translation and for reference translation. For predicted translation, we see that diversity in memory does not depend on the length of the sentence. And for reference translations, when the length of the translation grows, the average number of unique tokens in memory declines. To conclude, we show that working memory improves the quality of machine translation. We found two relations between working memory content and translations. First is with the growth of length of the reference sentence, the average number of unique tokens stored in memory declines. And the second is that for more complex texts, the average number of content words in memory correlates with the length of the predicted translation. And we also found three effects of translation complexity on working memory features. First is, for more complex texts, working memory contained more unique words, more parts of speech, and more content words. Second is that in memory related to the VSC samples, which contain more complex texts to translate and to understand, one and two content words occurred more frequently than for simpler texts from TED dataset. But for TED sentences, one or two translation keywords appeared in the memory. And for VSC, we found no such keywords in memory tokens. Thank you for your attention. I'm ready to answer your questions.
Thank you very much. Are there any questions? Please.
Very interesting talk. I know there's been a lot of, I've seen a number of demonstrations of transformers that do more long-range memory. Does your working memory also, how far back does it extend? How many, if I put a book in it, like how many, what sentences will it remember by the time it gets to the end of the book? And can it translate like a whole chapter at once, for example?
Okay, so here in the in our research, we bounded the number of memory tokens to 10. So we use not more than 10 tokens for memory. And our data we experimented with contains each sample, for example, may contain one or not up to three sentences, I guess. I haven't experimented with longer texts yet, but hope it's in plan.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for question.
Any other questions?
I have a question. Is it possible to, if you were to generate sentences, is it possible to construct such sentences that do not stay under your working memory boundaries? I mean, you could construct, let's say, noun phrases that are very long.
Mm-hmm.
Would that be possible?
You mean noun phrases, to store noun phrases in the memory?
I'm wondering whether this is a property of the natural language data set, that you have those limits, or whether it is a property of the network.
Okay.
It seems to me you found a confirmation that texts are constructed to respect certain expected boundaries that come from so those expectations would be suggested by neurological and psychological cognitive psychology works. So that's very interesting. Could you look at what happens with let's say strange sentences that try to break your system?
That's interesting. Yeah, thank you. Maybe I can comment about the length of the working memory.
Mm-hmm.
So the boundary came, the idea of bounding working memory to 10 tokens came from the from practical side, I think, because firstly, in experiments, we tried to not limit working memory and just let the model generate as much tokens as it needs. But it turns out that if we do not bound the memory size, once the model generated the first memory token, it continues generating memory forever. So it doesn't stop generating memory by itself. So that's why we had to do it manually. And if we to make a boundary, if we found, for example, 11th token, which goes to the memory, where what model says which goes to the memory, we turn it manually to the token of translation prediction, and then when the model finds at the next step of the generation, when the model finds that the last predicted token was the token of the translation, it starts generating the rest of the translated sentence.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Because we are behind the schedule, we need to move forward. And we are moving to the block of talks from the department of Professor Jan Truhr. And the first talk is by Isabel Clemente and Mariette Wiemann. If you are here, could you please?
Yes, we're here.
Great. Please share your screen. Introduce yourself and start the talk.